He said, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you. So after you have done what I taught about destroying the flesh by the cross of Christ, as you continue to do that, the process of resurrection also starts simultaneously, because you now start learning new things. Like before, I used to watch pornography and all that. When I started destroying my flesh and killing my flesh, I started seeing new possibilities. I started seeing new things. That's when I was now able to watch documentaries, to watch Christian TV, things that will now boost my spirituality. And now I tell you, I'm living a kind of life that sometimes I'm amazed. Is it possible for a human being to live like this? My wife can testify to what I'm saying, that I am a different man. All right, so Romans 8:11, it talked about the resurrection part. Then ascension is in the ascension, that is the third level a believer goes through, and that ascension goes on till Jesus Christ comes. Goes on till Jesus Christ comes, and that is 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17. He said, now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Verse 18. But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even by the Spirit of the Lord. That is talking about ascension, the third stage. And once you continue ascending, your sanctification starts to speed up. Your holiness starts to speed up, because you will be practicing the thing. Holiness for human beings is a practice. It's not a state. Holiness for God is a state. That is the state God is. God is holy. There's nothing, no reduction, no increase. God is just holy. But for us, the holiness required of us is a progressive holiness, progressive sanctification. So when we go through the process of death to self, then the good things is raised up. You say, quicken your mortal body. The power of God. God starts to release his power in you, and you are renewed. You are brought into new life. Then the process of ascension, like the Bible said here in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17 and 18. You continue in holiness and you increase in holiness. So this is the revelation. I believe the Holy Spirit that taught me these things has revealed it to you, as I've been able to share it. After this time, the Holy Spirit will confirm the things I'm saying to you. One of the things happening in the world right now is that everything that has to do with the cross and the finished work of Jesus Christ is fought against. There are people right now that are removing the cross from the churches. The symbol of the finished work of Jesus Christ, which is the cross, is being fought against by men. Why? Because the devil is inspiring men that if we can take away the cross, if we can take away Jesus Christ, that is everything that has to... Men don't have problem with God. Men will tell you they love God. But when it has to do with Jesus Christ, the Son of God that saved the world, that is where the problem is. And the cross, because the cross is the symbol of death, a lot of people run away from it. But the same cross that is the symbol of death is the instrument that brings new life. Because it's the same instrument that Jesus used to defeat the devil. And it was at the cross Jesus Christ said, it is finished. The cross has been brought to the center stage. The cross has been lifted up, just as you've seen before the program started. The cross has been lifted up to say, Jesus finished this work. And we are benefiting from what Jesus finished. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to me. No man cometh to the Father except by me. Today, as you have received this word, as you have believed it, I want to pray for you. You have not known Jesus Christ before this time. I want to pray for you that as you accept Jesus Christ, everything that I've shared in this video, you can benefit from it. You can't get the benefits until you give your heart to Jesus Christ. As you give your heart to Jesus Christ, all the seals will be open. And I believe you are ready. Let me pray for you. I want you to pray with me. Say this after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you. I'm a sinner. I cannot save myself. I believe your word. I believe you died on the cross for my sins. Come into my heart. Forgive me for my sins. Cleanse me by your blood. I now confess you as my Lord and my Savior. Father, in the name of Jesus, for this one that have prayed and accepted you into his heart, into our heart, I ask, O Lord, that you put the seal, the mark of the Holy Spirit upon this child. Your word declares that there is rejoicing in heaven at the repentance of one sinner over 99 that are righteous. Cancel our name from the book of death and put her name in the Lamb's book of life. In Jesus' name. I declare you blessed. You have given your heart to the Lord. The next thing you need to do now that you have watched the video, you now know the seals, the secrets, the revelation. Now it's no longer a secret. You have now received the revelation of what Jesus did at the cross to set you free from your flesh and every other addiction and entrapment of the flesh. The next thing you now need to do is to check on this same channel or go to my website www.sexuallyfree.blogspot.com and be part of the teachings, the seminar, the 12 weeks course that teaches you how to maintain this new freedom. He said, if the Son shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. On my website, you will see the manual for the seminar. I take one topic for every week, and the topic is taught, and you are given the whole week to practice what is being taught. And in 3 months, if you are able to focus, if you are able to learn and practice what is being taught, I believe that even from this video, you are set free from whatever is holding you down. But the 12 weeks is to train you so that you can set others free. And I'm going to pray for whoever you are right now, whatever you are facing, whatever is your addiction, whatever you're struggling with. And I speak in the name that is above every other name. I call you forth and I declare you free from whatever is holding you down. I command those chains broken. I command those chains, those ropes taken away. I see you set free right now. He that the Son shall set free is free indeed. Be free from this addiction. I command you, forces of darkness, lose your hold from that person. You have no hold on the person because the person believes. Your hold is broken right now. In Jesus' mighty name, I declare you free and I see you free. God bless you. This is the revelation. Go and practice it. As you have received the word, be doers of it also. I'll see you in another video. Thank you for having me on this channel. And I thank God for your life and I bless you. See you and bye for now.